Hi guys! Salamat sa inyong patuloy na ginagawang pagsubaybay dito sa ating discussions about mechanics of deformable bodies. Ang topic natin ngayon guys ay about statically indeterminate members. At meron akong inihandang tatlong problems para sa inyo para lalo nating maunawaan itong topic nating didiscussin sa ngayon. Guys, mag-start tayo with a simple definition of what is statically indeterminate member. Pag sinabi natin statically indeterminate member, ito ay tumutukoy sa isang condition that exists when the number of unknowns is more than the number of equations that can be formulated out of conditions of static equilibrium. Kapag daw ang number of unknowns ay higit na mas marami kesa sa doon sa number of equations na pwede nating mabuo kung ang pag-uusapan natin ay conditions of static equilibrium, then the system is said to be statically indeterminate member. And there is actually a general principle in solving problems that deals with statically indeterminate member. Kumbaga, kay madali lang siyang sundan basta maunawaan natin kung ano itong kay general principle na ito at in-apply natin. Pag nagsosolve tayo ng statically indeterminate member, then we can easily solve the problem. And here is the general procedure. First is to apply to a free body diagram or part of it the equations of static equilibrium. Ang ibig sabihin nun, we consider the whole structure or any part of that structure as free body diagram, and then from it we apply the conditions of equilibrium. Ano ba yon? So we may apply the summation of moment equal to zero, or we can apply the summation of forces in any direction equal to zero. And then if the number of unknowns is greater than the number of independent equations of equilibrium that is obtained, okay, from the condition of equilibrium, then we consider the system to be composed of statically indeterminate member. And then what shall we do? What we should be doing is to obtain additional equations from geometric relationship between the elastic deformations produced by the loads. And in order for us to be able to easily obtain the geometric relationship between the elastic deformation, okay, this can be defined by drawing a sketch that exaggerates the magnitude of elastic deformation. That is by imagining what will happen to the system when the system is subjected to the loading condition. Ang ibig sabihin nun, kay ma-imagine natin kung ano ba yung mangyayari dun sa sistema kapag yung sistema ay na-applyan na ng loads. Ano? So as much as possible, we draw a sketch that will exaggerate the deformation, and from the deformation, we try to establish anong relation ang nabuo mula dun sa mga elastic deformations ng materials involved. Now, let us have here an example. Ano? Okay. This actual example is taken from the book of Singer, Strength of Materials by Andrew Pytel and Ferdinand Singer. And here is the problem. A homogeneous rod of constant cross-section is attached to an yielding support. It carries an axial load P. Show that the reactions are given by the formula R sub 1 equals PB over L and R sub 2 equals PA over L, where B, A and B are the lengths from which the force is measured from the two end supports, and the length L is the length of the material. So here is the illustration, guys. We have here an homogeneous rod of constant cross-section having a length equal to L. And somewhere here, okay, there is a load P applied directed to the right. The position of this P is measured from the left support as A and from the right support at B. And from here, we wanted to determine what is this magnitude of the reaction R sub 1 on the left and R sub 2 on the right. And from the problem, from the problem, we are required to show that the magnitude of this R1 is equal to the product of this P multiplied by B divided by L. or the magnitude of this R sub 2 is the product of P multiplied by A divided by L. That is what we are going to do. Now, in order for us to be able to solve the problem, let us try to consider the whole structure as free body diagram, and then apply natin dito yung conditions of equilibrium. So if this will be applied with the conditions of equilibrium, that is summing up forces horizontal, what are we going to have? We shall be having the equation that R sub 1 plus R sub 2 shall be equal to B, if we will consider the leftward direction of the force to be positive. Hence, from here, we can solve that R sub 1 is equal to the difference between P minus R sub 2, and we call this as our equation 1. At pwede rin masabihin natin na yung R sub 2 is equal to P minus R sub 1. Ano? And then because we cannot anymore have additional equations from this condition of from this free body diagram, we cannot apply summation of moment equal to 0. We cannot apply either summation of forces vertical equal to 0. Lumalabas dito, we have two unknowns, R sub 1 and R sub 2, and we only have one equation formulated, that is summation of force horizontal equal to 0. Hence, since the number of unknowns is greater than the number of equation that we have formed, then our condition is that we have a statically indeterminate number. And then what shall we do? Sabi dito, we shall be obtaining the geometric relation between the elastic deformations of the materials. So for us to be able to solve for this, ano ba yung sinasabi ditong materials? Ano? Because we only have here one a homogeneous member or rod. So when we say material, these are the materials that that is composed of the two segments where the force is located. Ang ibig sabihin natin, we have to consider what will be the elongation that this P will be causing on segment A, and what will be the deformation that the same P will be causing on segment B. Diba? So let us try to differentiate the two segments by changing the color of the segment B. And let us try to animate. Okay, what will happen to segments A and B when P is applied? And in this particular case, I will show you a simple animation of what will happen to the member. Now, tingnan natin kung anong mangyayari sa pamamagitan ng animation na ating ginawa para sa problem na ito. This is what will happen. Okay? Nakita ninyo? What happened to A is that it increased to A prime, and the B is somewhat decreased to the B sub B prime. Ano? So kung titingnan natin, this portion from this point up to that point is actually the elongation or deformation of segment A, which is the same as the deformation of segment B. And as such, we can say that the relationship between the deformation of segment A and B, by looking at the illustration, is that they are equal. Hence, the deformation of A is equal to the deformation of B. But we have in the problem mentioned that the material is homogeneous, the material is constant, has constant cross-section, and if you are to assume that the material will not exceed the elastic limit, then the formula for finding the deformation of the material can be taken using PL over AE. So that if this formula shall be substituted in this equation, that we shall be having the PL over AE of the segment A shall be equal to PL over AE of the segment B. And because we have the same cross-sectional area and the same modulus of elasticity, therefore AE of A will cancel with AE of B. And what will happen is that we will have P of A is to the length of A shall be equal to P of B is multiplied by the length of B, which is equal to B. But we know that P sub A is equal to R sub 1, and P sub B will be equal to R sub 2. Yung tinutukoy natin dito, P sub A, yun yung internal force that will be acting Okay, on this segment, kapag ating in-isolate ito at kinonsider natin yung cross-section ito, makikita natin that yung P sub A, the internal force acting on segment A, will be equal to R sub 1 at ito ngayon. Samantalang, pag nagpas tayo ng exploratory section dito sa bahaging ito, makikita naman natin na yung P sub B will be equal to R sub 2. Kaya, sabi natin that if P sub 1, I'm sorry, R sub 1 is substituted to P sub A, and R sub 2 is substituted to P sub B, then our equation becomes R sub 1 multiplied by A shall be equal to R sub 2 multiplied by B. And if we're going to substitute our equation coming from or obtained from the condition of equilibrium, that R sub 1 is equal to P minus R sub 2 in this formula. Therefore, our equation becomes, okay, the quantity P minus R sub 2, okay, multiplied by A shall be equal to R sub 2 multiplied by B. Then if A will be, okay, distributed to all the terms here, therefore what we will have is that PA minus R sub 2A shall be equal to R sub 2B. If we will rearrange, okay, rearrange the term so that, okay, R sub 2, this will be transposed here and PA will be transposed on the right, then our equation becomes R sub 2 times the quantity A plus B shall be equal to P multiplied by A. But what is A plus B equal to? If we are going to look at the original illustration, A plus B is equal to L. Therefore, okay, we note that A plus B is equal to L. Therefore, if this will be substituted, our equation becomes R sub 2 shall be equal to PA over L. Furthermore, if we are going to substitute that R sub 2, this one, ano, from here, shall be equal to P minus R sub 1, and that is substituted here. Now, if we're going to solve for R by transposing R sub 1 to the right and this to the left, therefore, we shall have here, and then rearranging the term, we shall have here R sub 1 equals P minus PA over L. And from here, we can simplify that by factoring P, which is equal, by factoring P, that is equal to P times the quantity L minus A over L. But what is L minus A? If we're going to look at the same illustration, L minus A is equal to B. Therefore, R sub 2, R sub 1 becomes PB over L. And that is how we can apply the conditions of static equilibrium and the relationship between the elastic deformation of the materials involved in solving statically indeterminate members. I have here second problem. The second problem was also taken from the book of Singer, and the problem is similar to this one, but I decided to select a composite figure like the one that I'll be showing next. And here is our sample problem number 2. The composite rod in the figure is stress-free before the axle loads P1 and P2 are applied. Assuming that the walls are rigid, calculate the stress in each materials. If P sub 1 is equal to 150 kilonewton and P sub 2 equal kilonewton. Now here is our illustration. Ano? This one is taken from the book. We have here a composite bars made up of aluminum that is hinged at the wall and connected rigidly to a steel. And the steel is connected rigidly to another bar, okay, the bronze, while the bronze is connected to a rigid wall. Okay, the properties of the three materials are given. The aluminum has an area of 900 square millimeter and a modulus of elasticity equal to 70 gigapascal, while the steel has an area of 2000 square millimeter and E equal to 200 gigapascal, while area of the bronze is 1200 square millimeter, okay, and while the modulus of elasticity is equal to 83 gigapascal. The lengths of the three materials are indicated as shown. So the load of 150 is actually acting at the junction between the aluminum and the steel, while the 90 kilonewton load is acting at the junction between the steel and the bronze somewhere here, ano? And we wanted to determine here the stress developed in each of the material when the loads are applied at the given point. Now, we understand that yung stress can be taken by dividing the axial load by the resisting area, where the resisting area is equal to the cross-sectional area of each of the material. Sa makatwid, if we are to compute for the stress, it follows therefore that we need to compute for the axial loads acting on each of the material, the aluminum, the steel, and the bronze. So, ibig sabihin, kinakailangan natin masolve natin yung forces that ang nag-a-act doon sa tatlong materials. But because here we have here a composite figure that is placed on a rigid wall, let us try to imagine that the walls, the reactions at the walls as R sub 1 and R sub 2. And from this, we can apply the condition of equilibrium. That is, if we're going to apply the condition of equilibrium, then we say that R sub 1 plus R sub 2 minus 150 minus 90 shall be equal to 0. And if this will be simplified, we shall have here R sub 1 plus R sub 2 equal to 240. So, but if we're going to imagine, wala na tayong ibang makikita pang equations na mabubuo considering the condition of equilibrium. So, lalabas, ito ay tinatawag nating statically indeterminate member kasi yung number of unknowns natin, R sub 1 and R sub 2, ay higit sa number of equations na nabuo natin. We only have here one equation formulated out of the condition of equilibrium, that is summation of force horizontal equal to 0. So where are we going to get additional equations in order for us to solve this problem? Sabi nga yan, we have to consider, coming up with additional equations from the geometric relationship. Pero before we show that, medyo ikikip ko na muna itong mga equations na na-formulate natin. So we have here one equation formulated and I will be keeping it here as our first equation, ano? Tabi ko na lang muna dito para pag nag-change tayo ng screen, hindi siya mawala, ano? So I have formulated one equation that is R sub 1 plus R sub 2 equals 240. Now, bago natin makita yung condition of equilibrium, let us try to imagine ano ba yung mangyayari doon sa ating members kapag in-applyan natin ito ng loading. Gusto kong ma-imagine ninyo what will happen to aluminum, what will happen to steel, and what will happen to bronze when this is subjected to a load given in the figure. So, asahan natin, ano? We can expect that from the illustration, aluminum will be subjected to compression, while the bronze will be subjected to tension. But we don't know what will happen to the steel. The steel could either be subjected to tension or compression depending on the magnitude of the resulting value of R1 and R sub 2, di ba? So, kung makikita natin dito, it is possible that steel would be subjected to compression and so that at the end, steel will be shortened. Gaya ng ipapakita ko sa inyo sa animation na ginawa ko para sa problem ito. Tingnan natin mabuti what will happen to the steel, aluminum, and bronze when this is subjected to the given loading. This is what we will what will happen. Ito mangyayari, ano? Makita natin na yung aluminum umikli, yung steel umikli din habang yung bronze naman ay humaba. So bakit nangyari na itong steel ay umikli din? Mangyayari ito kapag yung steel ay na-subject sa compression. At yun ay kung itong R sub 1 natin ay higit na mas malaki kesa dun sa ating first load na 150. Pero pwede rin mangyari naman dito is that itong ating steel ay magkaroon din ng elongation, ano? Elongation din na mangyayari naman yun kapag yung steel ay na-subject naman sa tension. At ito yung makikita natin mangyayari. Ito yung posibleng mangyari. Humaba itong bronze. Diba? Nagkaroon din ng konting paghaba itong steel at yung aluminum naman ay umikli. Ano? Humaba yung steel, humaba din yung bronze, pero umikli yung aluminum. Samantalang sa itaas kanina, itong aluminum at saka yung steel ay parehong umikli at humaba naman dito yung bronze. Ba? Ngayon, ipakita natin. Ano? Kinakailangan kasi nating makabuo tayo ng additional equations para masolve natin itong R1 plus R2 equals 240. Ngayon, balikan natin. Kung pag-uusapan natin ay axial loads that would be acting on the three materials, let us try to pass an exploratory section. Ano? Okay, ganyan kasi mangyayari doon. Ano? Pakita natin kung mag-pass tayo ng exploratory section dito sa aluminum, diba? and we try to isolate the left part of the exploratory section, then our section will be shown as this one. This segment of the aluminum will now be exerted to an internal force P sub aluminum. And to balance the effect of the external load that is acting on the left, therefore, aluminum will be subjected to compression. So ito yung tinatawag nating P sub aluminum, and aluminum will be in compression. At yan nga yung dahilan kaya nga nakita natin na nagkaroon ng shortening yung aluminum. And if we are to consider applying the condition of equilibrium, therefore, okay, aluminum natin will be equal to R sub 1, which can be used in solving for the deformation of the aluminum, which is equal to PL over AE. Diba? So, pasamantala, kunin ko muna itong equation na ito na nakuha natin that the P of aluminum is equal to R sub 1. At dali natin dito sa part na ito para maipon natin yung mga equations. Ano? Pangalawa naman, subukan natin na mag-explore tayo at magpas tayo ng exploratory section dito sa steel. Diba? And similarly, we try to consider the left part of the exploratory section. If you will be applying the left part of the exploratory section, therefore, there will now be an internal force acting on this steel. But we don't know how it will be directed. Now, dito nga papasok yung condition na when it will be subjected to compression, this will be shortened. And when it will be subjected to tension, it will be elongated. Diba? Ngayon, kailan ba siya magiging subjected sa compression? Tingnan natin mabuti. I have here 150 and I have here R sub 1 as the forces acting on the left. Now, if R sub 1 will be greater than 150, kung sakali itong R sub 1 ay higit na mas malaki dito sa 150, ano ngayon ang force na mag-act dito internally on the steel? We would expect that the force acting on the steel is a force that is directed towards the section, hence the steel will be subjected to compression. At dahil nga compression siya, kay yung steel natin ay iikli, magkakaroon ng shortening yung ating steel, di ba? And what will be the magnitude of the steel? If we are to apply the condition of equilibrium, therefore our equation becomes R sub 1 minus 150 minus P of the steel shall be equal to 0. And from here, we can have P of the steel shall be equal to R sub 1 minus 150, which can be used to solve for the shortening or the deformation caused by this P of the steel on the steel. And this will be K equal to, okay, deformation of the steel equal to PL over AE of the steel. So, pasamantala, kunin ko muna itong part na ito, okay, at ipunin ko dito, okay, para magkaroon tayo ng relationship, what is our, okay, PS or P of the steel in terms of R sub 1. So, nakuha natin that P of the steel is equal to R sub 1 minus 150 and is subjected to compression. Again, this is when okay, R sub 1 is equal to 150. Diba? Pero tingnan natin, posible rin kasi na mangyari na yung ating R sub 1 ay mas maliit naman sa 150, di ba? So, if you will be applying, okay, if you will be passing an exploratory section in the same segment, and we consider the left-hand side of the exploratory section, and then we assume that this R sub 1 is less than 150. Ano mangyayari kung in-assume natin siya na 150? Sa magtuwid, itong steel now will be subjected to an internal force na mababaliktad ang direction na gaya ng ipinakita ko kanina. Sa magkatuwid, itong steel ay masasubject ngayon sa tension. Sa magkatuwid, there will now be a tension. And the magnitude of this steel can be considered, can be taken, if we will apply the condition of equilibrium, that is summation of force equal to 0, as such, R sub 1 minus 150 plus P of the steel shall be equal to 0. And hence from here, P of the steel will be equal to 150 minus R. Take note, this is when R sub 1 is less than 150. And this will be in tension, ano? In tension. So that if we have computed for the P of the steel, we can now compute for the deformation of the steel using the same formula that this is equal to PL over AE. Okay, bago natin iwan to, kunin ko muna itong bahagi na ito para maipakita natin that I would have here the P of the steel when R is equal to or less than 150. Gusto kong tingnan natin yung kuha natin. Ha? Sa kaninang assumption natin, if R is 150, lumalabas kay yung P of the steel is the difference between R and 150 and still would be subjected to compression. However, in our assumption that R is less than 150, ang value ng PSL naman yung kabaligtaran. That is 150 minus R, and the direction will be opposite. This becomes intention, di ba? So, paano naman kung ano naman yung ating P of the bronze, ano? P of the bronze. So, if we are going to pass an exploratory section or anywhere on the bronze, and if we will consider also, okay, the left-hand side of the equation, ano? I would be considering the left-hand side of the equation. Maring tanong nyo, bakit left-hand side pa rin? I do it because I wanted to express my actual loads acting on the member in terms of only one, okay, unknowns, and that is R sub 1. Para yung aking P sub bronze dito can be expressed also in terms of R sub 1. So makatwin, isa na lamang ang aking pinag-iisipan. I am all expressing the actual loads on the aluminum, on the steel, and on the bronze in terms of the reaction at the left. And if we are going to consider the left-hand side of the equation, then we shall be having, okay, P of the bronze to be subjected to tension. Ba? Okay, to be subjected to tension. And this can be taken by applying the condition of equilibrium that R sub 1 minus 240 plus 2 P of the bronze shall be equal to 0. And as such, yung ating bronze will be equal to 240 minus R sub 1. And okay, from here, we can say that this is subjected to tension, which can be used in solving for the deformation on the bronze, which is equal to PL over AE. Now, before we leave this part, kunin po na natin itong part neto para magamit natin reference in solving later on, okay, for the value of okay, the actual load on the bronze. You will notice that I have here formulated 5 equations. Ano? Yung unang equation, yung ating equations of equilibrium na nakuha natin when we consider the whole structure as FED. Yung pangalawa hanggang panglima, to P sub AL, P of the steel, and P of the bronze are all, okay, the expression of the actual loads on the materials expressed in the same unknown R sub 1. Diba? Now, if we're going to consider, okay, how are we going to obtain our geometric relationship? Kasi nga sabi dito, kung ang ating equation ay hindi sapat, okay, base dun sa number of unknowns na meron tayo, considering the static equilibrium, then we obtain additional equations from the elastic deformations of the materials. So how are we going to get that elastic deformation? Now, let us go back to this okay, illustration, and let us try to formulate the relationship that between ano, the deformation that will be formed from aluminum, from the steel, and from the bronze. And we will be assuming here that our reaction on the left is greater than 150. Sabihin, greater than 150, yung steel natin will be subjected to compression. Tama ka, tweet, yung steel will be shortened. Ano? So, pakita natin. Ganito yung mangyayari. Gusto kong obserbahin natin mabuti kay anong nakikita nating value, anong nakikita nating relationship. Okay? Obserbahan natin. Umikli yung aluminum, umikli din yung steel, pero humaba yung bronze. Diba? Now, sabi dito, because the walls are rigid, then the sum of the deformations of the material is equal to 0. Pag inad natin yung tatlong deformation na yon, dapat yan ay 0. Pero, kita natin na yung aluminum ay umikli, steel ay umikli, bronze ay umaba. If we will be giving sign for those compression to be negative, therefore, okay, those that are subjected to tension shall be positive. Hence, our equations become equal to negative deformation of the aluminum minus deformation of the steel plus deformation of the bronze shall be equal to 0. That if the formula for deformation shall be substituted, okay, whose formula is equal to PL over AE, therefore we shall have here PL over AE of the aluminum minus PL over AE of the steel plus PL over AE of the bronze shall be equal to 0. But P of the aluminum is already taken to be R sub 1, di ba? Okay, we are given L, that is equal to 500. A and E are also given in the problem. So that if all of those okay, values will be substituted in these general equations, P of the steel is taken to be here, assuming natin that steel is, R sub 1 is greater than 150, therefore we shall be substituting P of the steel to be equal to R sub 1 minus 150. And P of the bronze will be equal to 240 minus R sub 1. Therefore, our equation becomes, let us substitute, R sub 1 times 500 divided by 900 divided by 70. Minus the quantity, R sub 1 minus 150. This is our P of the steel. Okay, times 250, the length of the steel, and 2000, which is the area, and 200, which is the GPA. Plus, for the bronze, I have 240 minus R sub 1, which is P of the bronze. Okay, multiplied by 350, divided by 1200, divided by 80, all of these shall be equal to zero. Now, if you have a more sophisticated calculator, you can enter this equation and you can solve for R sub 1 so that R sub 1 can be solved as 77.6049 kilonewton. Okay, gusto kong tingnan natin mabuti. Ha? Ang assumption natin dito is that R sub 1 is 150, greater than 150. Pero lumalabas, R sub 1 is 77. Ang ibig ba sabihin ito, mali tayo. Hindi pa rin kasi ito pa rin yung tamang value na makukuha natin for R sub 1. Ano? Okay, for R sub 1. Nagkataon lamang na okay, yung R sub 1 natin ay hindi lumagpas ng 150. Pero, okay, mananatili pa rin tama pa rin yung ating R sub 1. Magkakaroon lamang siya ng epekto dun sa value ng ating R sub ng P of the steel, because P of the steel is expressed in terms of the relationship between R sub 1 and 150. Diba? Kaya, since R sub 1 is still 77.6049 and this is equal to P of the aluminum, therefore, P of the aluminum natin will also be equal to 77.6049. Diba? And if this will be substituted in the steel, we shall have here P of the steel to be R sub 1 minus 150. That okay, if we are to substitute the value of R sub 1, which is 77.6049, our P of the steel becomes equal to negative 72.4. Ito na yung medyo may tanong. Lumabas 72.4. Ang ibig ba sabihin ito? Mali. Ibig sabihin ito, the negative here would simply indicate, that the direction is opposite the assumed direction. Diba? Ang ibig sabihin ito, okay, ganito mangyayari, ano? Kanina, nung in-assume natin yung R sub 1 to be greater than 150, ano ang nangyayaring sense or direction of the force acting on the steel? We are assuming, therefore, that the steel is subjected to compression. But because our sign is negative, it indicates that the correct direction of the force on the steel, which is supposed to be, which is assumed to be in compression, is opposite. Hence, the actual direction of the force acting on the steel is opposite of this direction, and therefore it should be subjected to tension. At nakita nga natin, okay, dahil nga subjected siya sa tension, lumalabas yung ating P of the steel is negative. Now, what therefore shall be our value of the P of the steel? Ganito mangyayari, ano? Ang ating steel will remain as is as 72.4. Lamang ang direction niya, ang nangyayari siyang tension. Kumbaga kung titignan natin, hindi ito yung actual condition na mangyayari sa steel, kundi yung nasa ibabang condition, ito yung mangyayari sa steel. Ano? So makikita natin dito na, okay, aside from this bronze na humaba, yung steel ay humaba din. Ano? At nakabaligtaran na nangyayari kaya nakita natin na yung steel ay umikli. Because in this case, R sub 1 is less than 150. Nakuha nga natin na only 77.604. And in that case, steel will be subjected to tension. And this is what actually happened to a steel. Now, if we're going to solve for the axial load on the bronze using this relation that P of the bronze is equal to 240 minus R sub 1, therefore P of the bronze becomes equal to 240 minus 77.6049. Hence, our bronze will be subjected to 162.3951 kilonewton in tension. And therefore, if we are to solve for the stress, stress will become equal to, for the aluminum, it will be equal to 77.609 kilonewton or 77.604.9 newton divided by 900 square millimeter. Therefore, our aluminum will be subjected to 86.23 megapascal in compression. while our steel will be subjected to a stress equal to 72,395.1 newton divided by 2,000 square millimeter. As such, our steel is subjected to 36.2 megapascal in tension. And finally, our bronze is subjected to 162,395.1 newton per 1,200 square millimeter. As such, stress in the bronze is equal to 135.33 megapascal in tension. So this is how we solve problems like statically indeterminate, particularly those that are made up of composite member. Our third problem is again a problem which was taken from the book of Singer, and here is the problem. No, I chose this problem because I have noticed that there are PDF file that shows solution to this. However, I noticed that in the later part of that solution, merong konting adjustment na kinakailangan kay maunawaan natin. Ano kasi doon sa nakita kong solution, medyo nagkaroon ng konting parang pagkalito siguro yung author on how the problem shall be solved. Ano? So, and here is the problem. Sabi dito, the assembly in the figure consists of a light rigid bar AB that is pinned at O that is attached to the steel rod and aluminum rods. In the position shown, bar AB is horizontal and there is a gap of 5 mm between the lower end of the steel and its pin support at C. Compute the stress in the aluminum rod when the lower end of the steel rod is attached to its support. Sabi daw dito, ito daw ay AB is rigid pero light, ano? It is supported by connected to two rods, AC and BC. AC is steel while BC is an aluminum. Okay, there is a gap of 5 mm between the lower end of the steel and the pin support at C. And it is desired that this lower end to be connected or to be attached to the support at C. The question is, what are the stresses in the materials when the lower end of the steel is connected or attached to the pin support? Okay, so again, so let us try to start by considering applying the condition of equilibrium to the whole structure or to any part of it. And in this case, we shall be applying the condition of equilibrium to the horizontal bar. And we will treat this as our free body diagram. Let us try to isolate that bar. Okay. And then we try to show those forces acting on the bar. At A, because it is subjected to tension, there will be P of S, axial load acting on the steel rod. And at B, there will be P of aluminum, the axial load acting on the aluminum. We have removed the pin at O here, therefore we expect that at O there will be a reaction, and we call this as R sub O. So if you are going to sum up moments about O, again, if you are going to sum up moments about O, which is equal to zero, therefore we are going to have an equation which is equal to PS multiplied by the moment arm of 0.75 minus P of aluminum multiplied by its moment arm of 1.5 shall be equal to zero. And from here, we can formulate an equation that P of the steel is equal to twice of the P of the aluminum. So mean the axial load on the steel is twice the axial load on the aluminum. Diba? Simplified natin yan, no? So, if we're going to examine, we cannot anymore apply additional condition of equilibrium, or we cannot anymore formulate additional equations out of the condition of equilibrium. And since we have two unknowns, aluminum and steel, but we only have one equation, therefore our conditions that we have here is statically indeterminate member. And again, to solve for the problem, we have to look for additional equations coming from the geometric relation between the elastic deformation of the materials. So let us now try to obtain additional equations from the geometric relation between the elastic deformation of the material. Sabi nga dito, paano yan? Paano tayo kukuha ng geometric relationship between the elastic deformation of the material? Okay? It's better to consider that, okay, we try to imagine ano ba yung mangyayari sa sistema kapag in-apply ng load. Okay? Mula sa kanyang original position, papunta doon sa kanya, magiging in-expect nating final position. Ba? So how are we going to formulate our condition of equilibrium? Siguro mas maganda dito, we try to imagine, here is what you are seeing here is actually the initial position of the bar, horizontal bar AB. Ba? So horizontal siya, and let us imagine that what will happen to the bar kapag itong lower end ng steel ay hinila natin papunta dun sa C. Diba? Again, i-animate natin to para makita natin kung ano yung mangyayari. Let us try to imagine that we animated this one. So ganyan makita, no? So in-slow down ko. So hinila ko yung C. Okay? Okay, yung ating bar, since ito ay rigid, nanatili siyang straight. However, hindi na ngayon siya horizontal. Ano? Hindi na siya horizontal. It is inclined somewhat, a very, very small inclination because the gap is very, very small. But I exaggerated para sa discussions na gagawin natin. Okay? So ito ngayon yung makita nating final position ng ating bar. At gusto kong tingnan natin yung initial position ng bar. So from initial position of the bar to the final position of the bar, we now try to formulate the relationship between the deformation. Puntahan natin itong A, di ba? Itong A, narito kanina, ngayon E, ito na siya, di ba? Samantalang itong B naman, narito kanina, ngayon E, ando na siya sa ibabaw, di ba? Okay? Ito yun, yung A. Yun, ito na yung ating B, ano? Now, let us try to imagine. Let us try to consider that this point, yan, yung distance niya from the original position to the final position, okay, B called as the displacement or the movement of point B. At dahil siya ay gumalaw dahil sa elongation ng aluminum, masasabi natin na yung okay, movement ng B is caused by the deformation of the aluminum. Hence, we call this as our deformation of the aluminum. Diba? Puntahan naman natin itong A na to. Diba? Makikita natin na itong okay, portion na ito, from this point up to that point, okay, represented by this red one. Okay, hindi natin siya masabing deformation ng aluminum alang steel. Pero masasabi natin siya na siya yung naging galaw ng A dahil umangat yung B, di ba? But I will be calling it as okay, movement of A, delta A. It's just denoted as delta A. Da? And we can see the relationship between the deformation of the aluminum and this movement of A, because we have here a similar triangle that will be formed. Itong triangle na malaki ay similar dito, di ba? Kaya we can formulate an equation that okay, ratio and proportion that the movement of B is to 1.5 ay proportional siya sa movement ng A is 2.75. But movement of B is equal to deformation ng aluminum, di ba? Okay, if we will be replacing okay, the movement of B as the deformation of the aluminum, therefore, our equation becomes the deformation of the aluminum is twice the movement of A. Okay, ito daw deformation nito ay doble ng galaw naman ng A pababa. Di ba? O kaya naman, okay, kaya naman, yung galaw ng A ay kalhati lamang ng naging deformation ng aluminum. Di ba? Bumaba yung aluminum pero bumaba yung A ng kalhati lamang because of the ratio and proportion of the triangle. Now, tingnan natin mabuti. Kung itong A na ito, eh, dadaling ko dito. Di ba? Daling ko dyan. Makita natin na, yung A ay hanggang dun lamang. Di ba? And there will be still a gap between the movement of A due to elongation of the aluminum and that of the joint at C. And there is a need for us to further okay, stretch the steel for it to be connected to the joint C. Hence, this must be called, will be called as the deformation of the steel. Diba? Kaya nga, inaasahan natin na kapag hinila natin yung steel, hindi bababa, hindi nangangahulugan na kinakailangan yung steel ay mag-induce ng 5 mm para okay, ma-connect siya dito. sapagkat pag hinila natin yung steel, yung aluminum ay masasubject sa deformation that would have this deformation. Diba? And the deformation will cause okay, the movement of A okay, in a downward direction. Hence, we only need to supply a load that will cause this deformation on the steel for the steel to be connected to the spin support at C. And from here, dito tayo ngayon kukuha ng relationship okay, ng kanilang deformation. Okay, kung titira natin itong part na ito, makikita natin na yung 5 mm gap ay equal sa sum ng okay, movement ng A at ng deformation that is supposed to be induced on the steel bar C. Hence, we can have here that the relationship between the deformation on the steel plus the movement of A will be equal to 5. But what is this movement of A? Kanina nga, pinakita natin that the movement of A is equal to 1/2 of the deformation of the aluminum. Hence, if this will be substituted here, our equation becomes okay, deformation of the steel plus 1/2 of the deformation of the aluminum is equal to 0.5. At ito yung tinutukoy ko na relationship between the elastic deformation of the steel and the aluminum. Diba? Nakuha natin siya mula dun sa okay, pag-visualize na kung ano ang mangyayari dun sa bar kapag in-apply na siya ng load at kinonekta na yung lower end papunta dun sa support at C. Diba? Now, if we're going to okay, use this equation and then substitute okay, the formula. Okay, the formula. That formula is equal to PL over AE. That is P of the steel, length of the steel, area of the steel, E of the steel. Shall be equal to plus 0.5 P of the aluminum, area of the aluminum, length of the aluminum, over area of the aluminum. Okay. Modulus of elasticity shall be equal to 5. And if we are to substitute okay, the P of the steel, which is equal to twice of the P of the aluminum, diba? Pinakita natin ngayon na that the P of the steel is twice the P of the aluminum, diba? As well as the length of the steel, area of the steel, and E of the steel in the equation, then our equation becomes ito na. Okay, I have here the length of steel of 1,995 because there is a gap of 5 mm. Okay, the area of the steel is given as 250 as well as the modulus of elasticity. Ganon din sa aluminum. The length of the aluminum is 2,000, area of the aluminum is 300, and E of the aluminum is 70,000 or 70 times 10 cube. Kaya pag simplify natin to, we have here an equation that involves only P of the aluminum. And from here, we can solve that P of the aluminum to be equal to 39,204.6. At dahil nga, we already have established the relationship that okay, P of the steel is equal to twice of the P of the aluminum. Hence, P of the steel will be equal to 78,481.2 N. And then from this relationship, okay, we can compute okay, the magnitude of the stress, that stress equal to P over A. That if P and A shall be substituted, our stress ng aluminum is 130.802. Whereas, for steel, we have 78,481.2 okay, divided by 250, and that we have here okay, 313.92 megapascal. Maring tanong nyo, alin sir yung aking tinutukoy na counting error o na nakita ko doon sa PDF, solution sa PDF. Nakita ko, ito yung part na nakita ko. No? Somewhere here, okay, ang ginamit niya is stress. Tama nga naman because P over A is stress. However, since kay the author already used the stress, dapat wala na yung 250. Pero in his form computation, nandun pa rin yung 250. Ano? Ganun din sa aluminum. Ang ginamit na niyang value dito is stress ng aluminum. And stress is already P over A. Therefore, dapat wala na yung 300. Stress na lamang over 70. And that's correct. So, nagkaroon siya ng counting error by still using or substituting or including the area of the material. Diba? So, I hope guys that you're able to follow our discussions on statically indeterminate member with the three problems that I have presented to you. Sana ay nasundan ninyo yung ating discussion at In the future, you can solve your own whenever you're given the same problem. I hope, guys, that you will continue following our discussions here in Mechanics of Deformable Bodies by subscribing to this channel. You know? And again, if your friends are not yet subscribed to this channel, I am inviting you to let them know that I have this channel that discusses this kind of subject. Once again, thank you very much for watching.